Okay, well, we're going to talk a little bit about keywords, and I'm going to show you the different ways that you can add a keyword and different things you can do with keywords. Keywords are metadata you add to your image. We can see over here that I have a list of keywords in my keyword list, and I have opened here my keywording panel, which gives me keyword suggestions and sets. You can actually purchase some of these sets for different purposes or make your own presets if you use some very often. I'm going to actually take this and show how I could put a keyword. So there's no keyword on this picture at this time. So I could click here and I could put Golden Gate, Bridge, which it is. I could put Ship. And if I was thinking compositionally, I could put Foreground, Middle Ground, Background. So you could have as many keywords as you want or as few, but make sure that they're useful. So once I've done that, and I come over here, I could choose the next picture, which has no keywords, and you'll notice that some of the keywords have clicked into my suggestions. So I'm able to actually just click on those and add. So now this one has these, Golden Gate Bridge, and so does this one. Another option I have, so here's another picture, Golden Gate Bridge again. Let's make this a little bigger. And I could take it and drag it onto the word Golden Gate Bridge. And it will add it to the list. So I can type it in, I can drag it. I also have the option, I go here, and I'm going to say Golden Gate Bridge. And then I have my paint can, and I can paint it on. And I can click and paint into many pictures as I want. In grid view, put my paint can away, come down a little bit further. I'll choose these. These all have Golden Gate. Let's go down one more. Choose these. Some of these have Golden Gate. See the little asterisks right there? Some of them are Golden Gate, some of them are not. So I could come here right now and type Golden Gate, and it will actually give me suggestions. So now they all do. I'm going to take those off and take down. So now I have four pictures that I want Golden Gate on. I could also drag all four of them onto the words Golden Gate Bridge. That would be one way to do it. So there's many ways to get keywords into pictures. Now, if I was in survey mode, which you can see is right here, if I click here or I type an N, and I want to add we'll add the keyword of sky, not for any reason except that I want to. Okay, so now this one, because I'm not in grid mode, if I go to this, these won't have sky because I'm in survey mode. Survey and compare mode will only choose the picture that is the most selected or active picture. You can see by the brighter light versus the lighter gray. Gray, middle, grayish, almost white. So the only one that's going to have sky on it now is the one that was most selected when I typed the word sky. Now in grid, if I type sky right now, then all the pictures that are selected, the active, most selected, and the others that are selected will get that keyword. If I want to adjust my keywords, so, and I do this quite often, let's come over here to my, and you'll see my keywords generally, and I've added a couple of random ones just now, but my keywords are sort of are in groups called People Plus, Places, and Projects. So if I go to my projects and I go to my class projects, you'll notice that I did something, which you're probably going to do. I called some pictures night, I called some night photo, and I called some night photography. You might have a misspelling, you might have all kinds of things. So I'm going to click on night, and you'll see that these pictures, maybe good or bad, but mainly bad, I'll have the keyword of night. These here have a keyword of night photo, and these have night photography. Well, I don't want three different categories, I've decided. So I could edit these and make them go away, but instead I'm going to select all and drag them to night photography. I'm going to come here and select all and drag them to night photography. And then I've decided I don't want night photo or night, so I can hit the delete, the minus right here in the keyword list. And that will just delete those keywords, and so therefore they're not being used in it anymore. And all of my pictures, I had to drag them first into night photography, but all those pictures are now in night photography. So that's a way you can correct things. I often have little problems like that. Now, foreground, middle, gone, background is a compositional term that I'm going to want to use in other pictures. And so I'm going to actually drag that to class projects and drop it. So now foreground, middle, gone, background is in class projects, which is in projects. What is interesting about this, and let's choose a better one. We'll go into place. So right now, if I go to Golden Gate Bridge, there are 37 pictures that have the keyword Golden Gate Bridge. So I'm going to go up to the text, and you can see Golden Gate Bridge is in California. I'm going to type the keyword California. Now, you'll see as we look at this window, California is not there. But Golden Gate Bridge is in California. Therefore, when I ask for all pictures with keywords of California, I do also get the different keywords that are nested inside of that topic. Not just, so there's the ones from Golden Gate, there's the ones from Hayward, there's going to be some later from Point Reyes, from SF MoMA, and other such things. So nesting keywords is very, very powerful. If you come here, and this is way advanced, not what we're going to get very deeply in, but just so you know, you can actually build your keywords as a spreadsheet, and then you can copy it as a text file. Then you can import this text file into, you can export it, clean it up, and import it again. And that's how I got this to look pretty neat today, although it's only a portion of my catalog. Okay, sorry. So if you want any keyword, if I want to see my pictures from Newfoundland and Labrador, click on this little arrow. And there are the pictures that have that keyword. Keywords are very helpful. We also have over here in our smart collection the 18,000 pictures I have that don't have keywords, kind of a problem that I will have to deal with at some point. So we're back to the words without keywords. And so what I was going to say next is, say that I take this image, which is bristlecone pines, what I have to be careful of is it's without keywords, but if I add one keyword, it will disappear out of the smart collection because my smart collection says the keywords must be empty. So what I recommend if you're going to work with this is you take a selection of pictures that need keywords, perhaps from the same area, so you can do group keywords. So here's a group of bristlecone pines, and I'll make a new collection. I can even call this temp 2 keyword. I'm not going to put it in a collection set, but I am going to include the selected photographs. And so now I can put as many keywords as I want on here. I can do bristlecone, pine. I can do snow. I can do landscape. Whatever keywords I need to use for this picture, I can do. And I'll straighten them up in my keyword list a little bit later. So when I go back to grid, this one has a keywords and these don't. I could actually click all of them. You can see that the active one, the most selected, is the first one. And I could come here for synchronizing metadata. And there's the keywords. I can undo, or I could have the copyright, but let's just undo the copyright and the creator and just put the, have it add the keywords. So now all these pictures that I chose have nothing on them. Okay. Did not work. Sorry, have to click that one. Now we synchronize. And now you'll see that all of them have that little symbol that suggests that this photo has keywords. The one next to it is because I have a GPS on my camera and it has GPS coordinates. Okay, so now when we go back to the without keywords, these pictures will no longer be in that set because they all have keywords. So without keywords is useful, but you do have to plan when you add the keywords. But once you add one keyword, the picture will disappear out of the collection of without keywords. Hope that was helpful about keywords. There's still more, and it's really, it's a project. It's something you want to do little bit by little bit. Once again, keep it simple and build it up, and we'll talk more about this as we go forward. Thanks for being here.